So here is Paluch waking up, and this is what we do every morning. He's a little bit close to the camera, but he's had a haircut. We gave him a little mustache, and we cut into his face a little bit here, and we rounded off his head. It's very hard once they've been shaved down to get a really, you know, poodle cut on them. But as you can see here, I can do anything to this boy, this very aggressive boy, that, you know, other rescue groups said no. Are you getting in the camera there? So anyway, Paluch, he will, just the sweetest boy. We're in bed. He's looking to put his head down on my chest right now. Here he goes. He's lying on my chest. It's hard to do this. But what a sweet, loyal boy. And he risked being euthanized. And this is very sad to me that people don't realize that these dogs in shelters just are terrified. They are absolutely terrified. So this is Paluchi at his finest right here. Let's see if I can move the camera further away so that you can see the loyalty in this dog's eyes and the love. And that's what I saw in the shelter. I didn't touch him. I didn't have to. I saw his eyes, and it was enough to know that this was a terrified, sweet poodle. So this is snuggle time on the bed. We do this every morning, and he's flipping over right now. This is what we do every morning. And it took him only 2 days to trust me. And then, sadly, it took him 2 weeks to actually kiss me. He didn't know how to show affection. He wanted affection, but he didn't know how to show it. And that was very sad, because poodles learn how to show affection after being given affection. So now he knows how to do it. And now he's playing as well. He's playing with toys. And he's just, you know, the sweetest, sweetest, sweetest boy. So this is a success story for sure. You know, when you rehabilitate them and they come out like this, this is such a success, and they can go into a new home and be loved. Of course, the sad part is that, you know, we love them while they're here, because we have to give them so much attention and so much love when we're rehabilitating that, you know, here I go, breaks your heart. You do it because you want them to go on to a new life, but you put in so much work and so much love to them that it is heartbreaking for us rescuers, because we love them, but we do it because there's another one coming around the corner anytime, and this guy deserves a really good home. I get asked all the time, why don't you keep them? But if I kept everyone, I wouldn't be able to rehabilitate another and let it go on to a good life. What we have to do, though, is trust that the person adopting them is not going to undo what we did and is going to carry on and give them the home that they deserve. And sometimes that doesn't happen, and that can be hard. But we do our best here to make sure that the homes we place them in, we do a home visit, we check references, we meet the people, and we hope that what they tell us is their word. And that's what we have to trust. So anyway, he's going to go to a new home. So another special dog got
rescued.